My name is Szamer and Matthew, the developer of The Garden Between. So tell us about your game.
So The Garden Between is a surreal puzzle adventure game. In the game, you don't actually control the characters, you control time. So you move time backwards and forwards to solve puzzles. Kind of follows the story of these two best friends who find themselves transported into like this surreal world of Garden Islands.
Okay.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. Pretty puzzle games.
Yeah, that's an interesting puzzle.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm guessing with the times and the puzzles, you fix puzzles while they move or something like that?
Kind of.
Before they get to the spot?
Yeah, so you can change the state of different things in the world to solve puzzles. So when you rewind, you might change the state of something, and when you go forwards, it's different again. We try not to go too far down, like, crazy cause and effect. It just gets a little bit ridiculous. But yeah, the core puzzle, like, the core goal in each garden is to collect the light and take it to the top. So different things take light away from you or give you light. And you can, like, mess around with like physics timelines and stuff like that. So,
what platforms is it on?
It'll be coming out next year on Steam, so PC and Mac.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you know what quarter of the year or whatever?
Just mid 2018. So.
Okay.
June, July-ish, give or take.
I'm guessing it's a single player. I'm guessing no.
Yeah. Single player. Single player narrative puzzle game. Designed to be about 2 hours long, so keep it pretty short and sweet for people who have busy life schedules.
So what was the development period like, and what was like your hardest struggle?
We've been working on The Garden Between for almost 3 years now. Just trying to like connect the story with the gameplay mechanics and everything else and bring it all together to make like a product. It's like a really long time to refine and work out exactly what that core thing was.
To make the puzzles like fit well and actually work. So do you have any gameplay stuff apart from this? Like videos on Steam or something like that?
You can find The Gardens Between on Steam. We have a wishlist page up there with videos. You can also just go to thegardensbetween.com.
Okay.
We actually recently released a 45-minute, putting in a slow trailer. It was like Netflix slow TV. It's like 45 minutes of game visuals with like all the music in the game. So we worked with Tim Shield, who's like a very talented musician. So you can find that on YouTube. Just Google The Gardens Between.
Do you have a music card?
Yeah. The Voxel Agents. There's a Twitter, the Voxel Agents.
Yeah, that's the best way I can promote you guys.
Yeah.
The game looks really cool. Has it got good stuff at PAX?
Like
lots of people coming to see it.
Yeah, it's been like...
It's full right now.
We've basically always had 4 people playing the game at all times, which is really good. Lots of people just stop and look at the visuals just because it's a little bit mesmerizing just to watch.
And I do like how it's like a little built.
It's not really good at like composing just small intimate spaces.
Yeah.
So yeah, each level is like a little island that you can spin around basically.
Yeah, that's really cool. Definitely better than a just like a flat plane land.
Yeah.
Well done. Hope it does well.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you. Thanks for the interview.
Thank you.